The competition is global, and the stories are ever-telling and unique. Documentaries in this year's Doc Utah Festival at Dixie State University are not only compelling, but are drawing record crowds since the International Film Festival began 8 years ago.
I didn't want this to be insular. I wanted this to open people's minds and go beyond the Red Hills, you know, out into the world, and how do other people think about things? How do they live? And I think this festival, and I'm very proud of the fact that it pays that concept off to a tremendous degree.
Since there is never a theme, the stories angle from all walks of life. 64 films are presented this year from 22 countries. The only criteria was to submit your film and see if it makes it in.
Well, I love movies anyway in general, and these are just terrific because you just learn so much. You know, it might be a small little piece about a new topic, but it's just fascinating, you know. So I've come every year.
The International Film Festival is not out to make a profit, but to educate and inform its viewers. Audience members are young and old, with students being the major focus of the festival.
I like watching documentaries because they give, they open people's eyes, basically open you to a new thinking, to a new ways of understanding other people, because moving here as a refugee, when I was coming here, people were treating me differently. But the way the Syrian movie, the refugee from Syria, if people watch this movie, probably they will have a different way, set of treating other people and understanding people.
Students and film buffs attended Doc Talk sessions to ask questions of directors about their documentaries, including costs associated with producing them.
We had 7 students in Alaska and 2 teachers while we were filming, and then the entire post-production process was done by students.
One film, Where the Wind Blew, has direct ties to St. George. The documentary is about the downwinders affected by radiation from atomic bomb test sites in Nevada and Kazakhstan that began back in the 1950s. The documentary showed the lasting effects of the fallout from radiation on village people, even 40 years later.
For 40 years, in those 2 sites, thousands of bombs were dropped or exploded underground. Nobody had really told the stories of what happened when those bombs were tested to the people that lived close to them. And it was particularly shocking in the Soviet Union because they clearly had no interest in the local population.
Claudia Peterson, who was featured in the film from St. George, traveled to Kazakhstan and met those impacted by nuclear testing there. Peterson lost her 6-year-old daughter and her sister to cancer, which she attributes directly to radiation fallout from the Nevada test site. She said she's glad the nuclear sites were shut down, but the long-term effects of radiation will impact lives for generations to come.
Because we're living with it, we're not dying at the moment, unless we, you know, some of the people that were exposed that were closer, but we're passing it on generation to generation, and it's just a snowballing effect. And DNA weakness, chromosome weakness, we're passing generation to generation.
Governments knew from the 1950s onwards the impact of radiation on the human body. They knew it was not a good thing.
The impact these films and others have on their viewers are no doubt eye-opening and life-changing.
But the heart and soul, to me, of pure filmmaking exists in the documentary format.
From Doc Utah at Dixie State University, Melissa Anderson, CEC News.